lift up those two hands and give Jesus thanks for answered prayers this evening. Give him thanks. Give him praise and celebrate him. Thank you, Jesus. And blessed be your name, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' precious name, we have given thanks. How many believe that we serve a prayer answering God? He does not only answer, he answers by fire. He answers speedily. He answers on the spot. You believe that what we pray tonight, God has answered? Give him a big hand of praise. And please, you may be comfortably seated. The essence of prayers is the answers we obtain. Prayer will remain a religious punishment if they don't culminate in answers. And we have to learn the rules of praying to secure answers. Then shall ye call, and I will answer thee. You shall cry, and I will say, here I am. Isaiah chapter 58 and verse 9. So prayer and fasting, among others, facilitates answers to prayers. Is this not the fast that I've chosen? And as you engage in the God-chosen fast, then shall ye call. And the Lord shall answer. Thou will cry, and shall cry, and he shall say, here I am. If thou take away from the midst of you the yoke, praise God. So whether for prayers or for fasting, there are things we must take away from our lives for God to respond. You ask and receive not, because you ask amiss. So we must learn how to ask aright. Otherwise, we keep missing the point and we don't return with answers. So our exhortation for this Shiloh prayer hour is captioned, praying the prayer that must be answered. Praying the prayer that must be answered. The man Elijah was too sure of his answering prayer God. He said, okay, get ready, and I'll get ready. And the God that answers by fire, let him be the Lord. He was too sure. And the God that answered, they said, well, and all the people said, it is well spoken. You will know today that Baal is fire, not that he answered by fire. And so, he prepared the altar of the Lord, and we have to do that. We have to prepare the altar of our life to reach out to the God that answers by fire. And he put 12 stones and built the Lord an altar. Got himself ready. We need to get ready to pray the prayer that must be answered. So today we look at this aspect of it. We must not assume forgiveness. We must consciously seek for it in order to pray the prayer that must be answered. Isaiah 59 verses 1 and 2. Behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened that he cannot save, neither is ear heavy that he cannot hear, but our iniquities have separated between you and God, your iniquities, and your sins have hid his face from you that he will not hear. So if we must pray the prayer that must be answered. We must not assume forgiveness. We must consciously seek for it. 1 John 1, 8 and 9. If we say we have not sinned, or we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. We must clear the barrier between us and the throne of grace where we command answers to prayer. That barrier must be broken. We must confess and forsake our sins and forgive those who sin against us. If we must pray the prayer that must be answered, we must confess and forsake our sins and forgive those who sin against us. Psalm 66 and verse 18 and 19. If I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. Now, verse 19, good news. But verily God has heard me. He has attended to the voice of my prayers. In Proverbs 28, verse 13, the Bible says, he that covereth his sins shall not prosper, but whoso confesseth and forsaketh them shall have what? Mercy. In Matthew 6, 12, Jesus teaching on prayer said, and forgive us as our debts as we forgive our debtors. And verse 14, he said, for if we forgive men, if you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your heavenly Father forgive your trespasses. We must clear these barriers to pray the prayer that must be answered. Number two line we are considering tonight is that we must pray according to his will to qualify for answers. We must pray according to his will to qualify for answers. That means we must locate his will concerning what you are praying and engage with it, believing. Then we are safe for an answer. In 1 John chapter 5, verse 14 and 15, the Bible says, and this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. And if we know that he hears us whatsoever we ask, then we know that we have the petitions that we have desired of him. Asking according to his will. Asking according to his will. We can be confident that he hears us. The reason is the scriptures cannot be broken. The Bible is the will of God imprint on any subject matter. We are about experiencing the greatest visitation in the history of this commission. And the Bible demands that we prepare the ground for it. And the altar of prayer is one fundamental preparatory platform for the move of God any day, any time. The move of God rides on the wings of prayers. We must have to pray to prepare the way of the Lord. We must have to pray to clear the way for the Lord's visitation. So we are praying according to his will. Praise God. It's his will to do what eyes have not seen nor ears heard, neither has entered the heart of any man, for all that love him. And now we are his bride. So we pray to see what eyes have not seen, nor ears heard, neither has entered the heart of any man. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. So we pray, oh Lord, grant everybody eternal rest as they come to meet with you. He says, we to appear to people in Shiloh. Oh Lord, let each one encounter your appearance at Shiloh 2017. Do things that we've never heard nor seen before. So we must pray according to his will. We must pray according to his will. He has made his ministers flames of fire. We pray for everyone ministering to come down from the altar as flames of fire. Can I hear your amen? Shiloh is ordained a place for conferment of dominion on the church. So we have the reason to pray that at Shiloh, let each one return with a seal of dominion on his forehead and change the dominion level of this church forever. Praise the Lord. Whatever name Adam called it, that was the name by which they were called. And so we have a right to pray, let it be a new dawn Shiloh for all participants. A new dawn Shiloh for this church. A new dawn Shiloh for all participants. Praying according to his will. Commit his integrity to answer. Because he cannot deny himself. Stand to your feet. Whatever you recognize as a barrier in your own life against full-scale delivery of answers to your prayers, lift up your two hands and call on the God of heaven for forgiveness, for mercy, or the hatred or the bitterness, whatever comes to the barrier between you and your God on the altar of prayer. Now, ask God to forgive. Everything you know displeases God in your life, now call for forgiveness. Call for forgiveness from the depth of your heart tonight. God forgave David all that he did as if he never did them. Now, ask God for forgiveness. There is no unforgivable sin in the sight of God. Ask God for forgiveness. Ask God for forgiveness. The unforgiveness that someone has provoked you to embrace. Now, ask God for forgiveness. Ask God for forgiveness. You want to experience raw answer to your prayers? Now, ask God for forgiveness. Ask God for forgiveness. You want to experience raw answers to your prayers? Ask God for forgiveness. Do it conscientiously, no assumptions. If you confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Now, ask God for forgiveness from the depth of your heart. Ask God for forgiveness. Now, ask God for grace to pray according to his will from henceforth on every subject of prayer you ever raise. Now, ask God to pray according to his will so you can command raw answers to your prayers. Now, lift up your two hands and pray. Pray that prayer from the depth of your heart. Pray that prayer from the depth of your heart. Grace me to pray according to your will on every prayer subject from henceforth. No more assumption. Grant me access to require revelation, relevant revelation on every prayer subject I engage with. Now help me, Jesus. Now pray that prayer. Pray that prayer. Pray from the depth of your heart. I receive grace from you to pray according to your will. According to your will from henceforth. According to your will from henceforth. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen. Give the Lord a big hand. Get seated.